review of Avatar, directed by James Cameron.
Showtime.
You are not in Kansas anymore. You are on Pandora.
You should see your faces.
We have an indigenous population called the Na'vi. They are very hard to kill.
This is why we're here. Because this little gray rock sells for 20 million a kilo. Their village happens to be resting on the richest deposit, and they need to relocate. Those savages are threatening our whole operation. We're on the brink of war, and you're supposed to be finding a diplomatic solution.
Looks like you. This is your avatar.
Did you forget what team you're playing for?
Strong prey on the weak. Nobody does a thing.
You got 1 hour.
You knew this would happen?
Everything changed.
Jake, it's crazy here. Quaritch is rolling and there's no stopping him.
We're going up against gunships with bows and arrows.
Well, I guess we better stop him.
They've sent us a message that they can take whatever they want. But we will send them a message.
That this is our land!
It has been over a decade since James Cameron directed a major Hollywood film, and it's hard to believe that since The Terminator was made in 1984, that he's made only 5 more Hollywood feature films in the last 25 years. It goes without saying that Piranha 2 The Spawning was not going to be his claim to fame. But once he wrote and directed The Terminator, and then followed that up with writing and directing of Aliens, he was going to be able to write his own ticket from then on. And if I were to rate his feature films from the original Terminator to the movie Titanic, I'd have to put them in this order. Number 6 would have to be True Lies. While it's not supposed to be a serious movie by any means, it was way too over the top for me. The beginning was decent, and the middle was okay. But by the end, it was just getting stupid. Coming at number 5 would have to be The Abyss. Now I like this movie. It had a great cast and the effects were actually pretty good for the time. Also, if you're going to watch it, make sure you see the director's cut. It's much better. I'd have to put the original Terminator at number 4. Now I know some people are going to rip me for this, but I would have to say that in all aspects, the other 3 films are better. Of course, this is a classic, but the top 3 are his best works to date, in my opinion.
I'll be back.
Even though Titanic has all the box office records, I couldn't put it higher than 3 on this list. And I actually didn't watch this movie for about a year after its release. But when I finally did see it, I wish I had watched this movie on the big screen. And what made this movie great was that it was able to end such a tragic story on a high note. Even though the Titanic story has been made into a film several times before, he was able to make it well worth watching again, and it earned every dollar it made. Another great version of the story of Titanic was A Night to Remember, made back in 1958.
But this ship can't sink.
She's made of iron, sir. I assure you, she can. And she will. It is a mathematical certainty.
What I think makes James Cameron one of the best directors in Hollywood is the fact that normally sequels are usually far inferior to the original. He was not only able to make 1 sequel that was superior to the original, but 2. And what makes it even more impressive is that he made a successful sequel to one of his own films as well as someone else's work. I'd have to put Aliens at number 2. Great film. And this was an exceptional follow-up to Ridley Scott's sci-fi horror classic, Alien.
Get away from her, you bitch!
Now, like most of this film, with the exception of the character Newt.
My name's Newt.
And they mostly come at night. Mostly.
And now back to the movie of the week, Aliens.
They mostly come at night. Mostly.
They mostly come at night. Mostly.
She mostly gets really mad. Mostly. And when I have you and your boyfriend's voices on my speak and record, Bear, then you'll mostly never babysit me again. Mostly.
I never realized how lame that line sounded until Trey and Matt pointed it out. Newt just seemed like a token character to me that really didn't need to be there. And that's why I'll always consider The Thing to be an all-time classic.
Hey, thanks for thinking about it, though.
McCready! Mac, get your gear on!
Every character in that film needed to be there. And that's what made the thing more believable to me. There were no distractions of a lame subplot.
This can't be happening, man. This isn't happening.
The number one movie on this list should be obvious to anyone watching this review. Terminator 2 will most likely always be his best work. While Jaws is considered to be the first summer blockbuster, T2 was the movie that everyone had to see that year. The buzz for this movie was amazing, and the effects still hold up to this day, which is pretty amazing considering it's been almost two full decades since T2 was in theaters.
Come with me if you want to live.
So once I found out that James Cameron was going to finally direct another film, I was going to make sure to see it on opening day. And I'd be very surprised if Avatar was not up to par with his other films. And needless to say, the effects for this film are groundbreaking. Now, the only concern I have for this type of technology being used in movies is that I hope the focus doesn't all go toward the visuals and not the plot and character development. And thankfully, that's not a problem for this film. So the main question is, will Avatar be another James Cameron classic? And I'd have to say yes. Not only is he a director, but he's a writer as well. So the stories that he directs are also his, not someone else's. And from seeing the trailer, you can get a pretty good idea of what this film is about and how much of it will eventually play out. But this did not ruin the movie for me. There was so much more to the film than some of the main story points shown in the trailer. I think my biggest concern, along with most other people, is would this movie suffer from the Incredible Hulk effect?
Hulk! Smash!
Once the actor turned into the Hulk, it was very hard to find it believable. Many people just could not stay attached to the character once the transformation took place. And surprisingly, this film didn't have that problem. The facial expressions in the eyes were captured extremely well for this film, which to me is a monumental task. Easily the strongest point for this movie is the visual effects. And I'll go on record saying that as far as the visuals go, this film has no equal. And there have been many movies made over the past 50 years that have set the mark for creativity, like Stanley Kubrick's classic 2001, and of course, Star Wars. This film is definitely in that category. The action in the movie was also top-notch, from the chase scenes, the fight scenes, to the final battle. It didn't disappoint in any of these categories. Now, one of the possible concerns is this film's runtime, of over 2.5 hours. And I will say that for its length, it never felt slow or sluggish. It starts relatively fast and keeps the pace at a good level so as not to bore the viewers. If I could sum this movie up with one word, it would be immersion. This film surrounds you in visual beauty and makes you feel as if you were there. But the storyline and plot are also strong. While sometimes predictable, it delivers each scene in a powerful, dynamic way. Many studios try to sell their movies on graphics alone, like the recently released 2012 or War of the Worlds and even The Day After Tomorrow. But this movie is on a whole other level. Even if you were to only see this film for the visual effects, it would still be worth the price of admission. The real test for any film like this is the ending. How are they going to tie it all up and make you feel satisfied when the ending credits begin to roll? And I'd say the ending did not disappoint. While watching the Star Wars prequels, the endings for episodes 1 and 2, it just didn't work for me. I felt like the good guys were never in any real danger. This film made you think that anyone was vulnerable. I'm sure there'll be people out there that will not like this film for whatever reason. But for me, Avatar delivered pretty much everything I wanted from a film of this nature. This film was creative, groundbreaking, and entertaining. And I believe this is one of those must-see movies at the theater. Seeing it in 3D on the big screen is what the future of movies is all about. And it starts right here with James Cameron's Avatar. For my overall rating, I give Avatar 4.5 stars.
That's it, man. Game over, man. It's game over.